Hello, YouTube! I am Penstar, and this is Hearthlands Strategy and Tactics, Episode 10. So, in our last episode, we had adapted to some of the changes in the patch, and we are contemplating our next city expansion, being that we are fairly close to maxing out our cities here, or at least we would have had them all maxed out already had we not keep bumping into supply shortages, which I am trying to patch up. So hopefully this alcohol and what have you gets distributed. We're gonna need more wineries here. But since these guys are just starting to harvest, I think that will take care of itself. But right now, we have a vampire to take care of. Now, the vampire is probably one of the hardest map threats in the game to neutralize. You're going to want to wait until you're good and ready before you tackle this guy, because he has a lot of hit points. He's got some damaging attacks. He drains life. He comes with ghosts. It's all kinds of crazy to go nuts. So I wouldn't have even attempted this had I not had 3 units of archers and 2 units of horsemen, plus some spells up my sleeve should I need them. So that being said, let us get ready. I'm going to put ourselves in formation here. Get some of our guys over here. Make sure our horsemen are in the front and our archers are in the back. And make sure we get all 3 of our archer groups. Okay, here we go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause, assign orders to everybody. Your Majesty, glory. And then they'll all take off in...
Orders, yes, my lord. Orders, yes, my lord.
Oops.
Yes, my lord.
And now we unpause and the fun begins. Come on, horsemen, it's not that hard. And there's the ghosts. I think it is worth our while to help them out with a spot of phantom warriors, just to help cut down on the casualties here. And there's the vampire. Now I'm hoping the vampire goes over to my archers, because he teleports. Every time he's hit in melee, he teleports. And the archers can just redirect their fire to him wherever he appears, so they're really good at taking him down. Whereas our melee troops are going to waste half their time just trying to pin him down. So yeah, as long as they... like right there, he's getting the full salvo of our archers. So they're already... He's almost down to half health. Now look at all these benefits he gets. He can't regenerate, but he's got 50% resistance to physical damage, teleports randomly, 50% resistance from magical damage. So he's got a 50% resistance either way you attack him. He's got a ranged attack, but not as long as an archer. And he restores his hit points for 50% of the damage he deals, and he does a lot of damage. So, yeah. Even when we're surrounding him and pounding on him like this. And yeah, it's just a big pain in the butt every time he goes like this. How is he doing? Oh, he's almost dead, though. That means that's good stuff. Of eggs, eh? Alright, hang on. I can do eggs. We can do eggs. We just need to not accept eggs. Not accept eggs. And temporarily stop trading them away. We'll be able to... Our chickens will be able to poop out enough of those. Although I might want to just temporarily import 2 loads of them. Alright, back in action. Our phantom warriors looks like they just disappeared, but I think we're good for now. Oh god, we got a turd monster coming our way. That's unfortunate. Hey, well, hey, at least the watchmen will start helping out. Watchmen versus vampires. Nope, and there he goes. He is dead. Oh, come on! We got another vampire spawn? Oh, you gotta be effing kidding me. Alright, let's set our eggs back to normal. Are you freaking kidding me? We got another vampire spawn from the mansion because we temporarily stopped attacking it. That's just BS right there. A steaming pile of BS. Oh yeah, we can go back to selling our eggs. And yes, please attack the effing mansion! And see, that's the thing here. He's just going to keep trolling our melee troops. If I'm lucky, our guys will continue to attack here. These guys will just keep the vampire busy while our archers actually do all the hard work. Well, I guess maybe that's not the end of the world. Because he'll presumably drop another resource, and we got the XP cup down here. No, don't go near our archers. We need the archers just to take out the damn building. And there goes the vampire on the archers. Alright, good. As long as somebody freaking... Ooh, thank you. As long as somebody is pounding on the damn mansion, then there's no chance for another reset here. How's he doing? He almost half health again. This is one long, drawn-out fight here. And our watchman is still bravely going on in there. Yeah, there you go. Take a face full of archers. Alright, yeah, keep churning out the units there. Well, alright, yeah, you guys keep firing on there. The vampire wanders up here. That's fine by me, too. Oh, no! Lost a civilian. Hey, our reinforcement archer's on it. How's this place? Almost dead. Well, we certainly won't get respawns when that place burns down. All right, we got it, and it's freaking fame. Somebody pick that up. Thank you. Ooh, well, what was that? Well, that was that. I missed what those things were.
Your Majesty.
Phew. Well, that, as they say, is that. We took some losses. We gotta lick our wounds. But I think overall, we did pretty well. Although I would have liked to have had a knowledge book. Yeah, you guys picked the wrong place. Alright, off you go. Alright, let's see how our economy is doing here. Alright, you guys are doing your thing. Extra room for 1200, that's fine. Alright, you guys are going on with the cotton. Dang, I really wish those guys would have dropped some books. I could have used some books. Well, let's see what we can buy with our lore as is. We already bought our majesty for the bonuses. Courtesy, maybe. We want more of this. maybe our next level of mining, get coal mines going. Now we're gonna, if we go for that, we're gonna want to push for the third level, which gives us iron and gold mines, which will allow us to just continue on endlessly and disgustingly. Actually, you know what? I think we're gonna grab distribution, get our people walking faster. Charisma. I don't need more fame. We're fine with fame. Let's be very honest here. So I think, you know what? We have 13. Yes, we do. All right, let's get level 2, and then we are going to save up for level 3 mining. Is there anybody who is just plain out buying coal? No, nobody is plain out buying coal, but we got people buying iron. So if we can get to an iron mine, like up there, and combine that, well, we got a coal deposit here anyway. So we might as well, actually. How are we doing? Well, we need more unemployment before we can do a big economic expansion. And before we do that, we need to expand our houses here, wholesale. And in doing that, we need to get more workers in. So here's what we're going to do. Let's make our buildings transparent here, because we're going to need to clear out a whole bunch of trees without clearing out any of our real buildings here, because we do not want to clear out the good stuff. Okay, so here is, oops, missed one of you. Here is our merchant road here. So we will run you down this way. Alright, well, I'm going to fast forward this part because, well, you've already seen this. Okay, we have built our, we've almost finished building our thing, can't forget this. But we're going to grow it slowly because we don't want to overmax out and overtax out our goods from, we don't want to poach goods from our other places here. So here's what we're going to be doing in order to prevent that. We are going to tell it to accept, to not accept pillows, boots, or clothing. Actually, Until we can get our production boosted up there using the population that comes here. So we've got enough, we certainly have enough food on hand. And as far as alcohol goes, actually don't accept alcohol yet. We're just going to give you food for the moment. We will greatly boost our alcohol production, well, at least as much as possible, to get you guys up the extra levels, along with more furniture. So that way we're not eating into the goods that these things, because even these guys are running low on clothing. We wouldn't want a whole other housing sector competing for people and competing for clothes until we get more population in. And yes, I know, not enough workers. Are we selling clothes? We should stop selling clothes. We are selling alcohol, but I don't want to stop selling alcohol because, well, we can get so much more of it. Another thing of feathers, eh? How are we on feathers? We are running short on feathers. We should not be selling so many feathers. I'm going to turn off selling feathers for the moment. And we are going to need more bread, too. Let me guess, you're buying bread? Nope, all right, they're selling bread. That's fine. But to say, he's like, the moment I have another thing that's going to eat up more food, someone wants to buy it. Nope, I was wrong. But I'm happy to be wrong in this instance. All right, how are we doing? Worker shortage still. Well, we still need to wait for our newcomers to come and fill the new blocks here. hopefully with that extra point of diligence, or not diligence, the logistics, the thing that makes the people work faster or walk faster, we'll be in a good place. Yeah, we're getting tons of stone in here. We should be able to open this up soon once we get more workers on hand. What? Are you kidding me? You literally just grew, and then the plague event struck before our apothecary could come and give you medicine. Oh my freaking god. Well, at the very least, 7 people might die. But that's about it. Bull bowel movements. But yeah, once we get our extra room going in here, I'll get more wineries going. That will allow us to go up to level 2 here, and then so on and so forth, so that we can grow our economy to grow this new housing section. That's why you want to make sure... speaking of medicine, though, one thing I do need to grow into is another herbalist shop. And this place has some plenty of mushrooms. And we certainly have the spare wood, so we'll want to make sure we get more herbalist shop going here so we can get more medicine produced, so we do not run short. Ready to serve. All right, our military is slowly growing itself back. Unemployment, let's do it. Yeah, slowly delivering all the goodies here, so that this thing might level up and give us an even bigger lore boost. Does it say how... No, it doesn't say our... Well, hang on. Our lore... Collected... Received, found... Yeah, I wish that would have been higher in the last year from that vampire. You'd think vampires have, like, a library in their house. You'd think. But such is not the case. Alright, there's the turd monsters. Right on schedule. Boy, I'm so happy they buffed Watchmen so that they could fight them effectively. How we doing here? 0% completed. I guess they're just waiting for more goodies. I really should get myself more iron production going here. How am I doing? It's still worker shortage, so I don't want to expand my economy too aggressively. Now, these guys aren't going to be consuming too much in the way of food. And bear in mind, most of our people... Yeah, we're running low on pillows. Am I selling pillows? No, I stopped selling pillows. Ooh, but I can sell stone for the moment. I'm okay selling stone. We're making enough of it. All right. Yeah, and we're loading up with all those textiles, so let's get more pillow makers, and also let's ensure our... All right, yeah, we do have feathers building up. That's good. I was about to say, if feathers are a shortage, we're going to need more chickens. But that does not look like that's the case. We've got 4 aviaries worth of feathers coming in. So I think we're going to be pretty good there. It's just a matter of this extra room for... Aha! It looks like we got our... we're building up our next level of university here. Stage building complete. 63%. We will get ourselves more lore, and that means more technology. And we also need more of those. All right, let's get another woodcutter plus sawmills... 2 sawmills plus 2 carpenter's shops. And of course our woodcutter can go all the way out here to be paired with one of these guys. No mushrooms, please. Thank you. Off you go. More furniture, please. Yes, I know, not enough workers. Just move here. We got room for 1,200 more people. I'm not going to go crazy trying to provide more goods to my new housing section until we get people moving in. Because then that's just going to cause you guys to level down. Hey, come on, guy. Get to him and give him pillows and such. Nope, no pillows? You didn't have any pillows to give him? Bugger. We're probably going to need to expand our cotton. Oh, and we need more boars. More boars. Go get them, guys. God, I love that spell. Oh, you know what we should do is we should turn these guys down off, because until we get our guys up to level 4, they ain't going to be doing much for us. So we'll push those workers back into the worker pool to work somewhere else. Oh, and hey, it looks like we're getting some alcohol in. I'd be willing to allow you to accept alcohol now. ...8% completed. It still looks the same. Oh, I guess there's a few more things. Are we getting a bonus to our lore generation, though? It's hard to tell. Economy overview. Yeah, we had two people die, but that's not enough to put too much of a dent here. Found production. Yeah, we're not eating nearly as much as we're... And yet, there's a food shortage of some sorts. Oh, we're accepting eggs. I'm not letting my people go freaking hungry here. Lingcomb! Boy, we can get all kinds of deals from you guys. And what the hey, we'll get some cheese. Well, again, this is more for diplomacy than... Well, it's also for food. Since that seems to be something we're running short on. I guess as more people move in, we are going to need to keep on top of that. We are burning through most of our grain here. Still buying most of it. I think it's because this guy is taking up a whole bunch of it. Still worker shortage, though. Not liking that worker shortage. Oh, well, thank you. But unfortunately, we're losing people here due to the food. All right, what other foods can we pick up? Eggs. We'll stop selling eggs. Stop selling grain. We're buying grain. Stop selling the worst. Continue selling the wine. That'll be our workhorse when it comes to getting our money's worth here. Is selling all that wine. Hopefully now with the worst coming in, we'll be able to feed our people. So I do not want to suddenly lose everything. Because that could turn into a very quick spiral. Yeah, go ahead, take it. 1,600 for a 27 bonus? I think that's worth it. And we're still... are we buying... Oh, yeah, we're buying too many textiles here. That is our issue. All right, let's see here. Yeah, we're still short on some food, but hopefully we get enough stuff coming in. Please give these guys some food before they all start leveling down. Does our peddler have food? He's only got a little food. How about you? No food. Not good. Where the hay is all that bread going? Come on! Not enough flour. Why are you... Not enough grain! Oh! Because we've probably outstripped our ability. Well, I did stop selling the grain, so that should hopefully stop it. That's probably why we're losing out on our food. Yeah, I'm not seeing any of these mills going. You have 5 grain. Why aren't you delivering? Whoa-ho! It's been a while since the goblins actually made it to us. Oh, hey, we found a thing, a bag of bread. That might be a little stale, but I think it's worth it here. Yeah, these guys can go up to the next level. We'll take in clothes. Still worker shortage. Yeah, these things aren't turning. Why aren't you... Are they all going to the chickens? Literally, are all the chickens eating the grain? Because, wait, why aren't they going here? There's grain sitting here. Why aren't you going to the mill? Game? And take our turn off that cider. You know what? Damn it. We gotta buy some flour. Keep our things busy. And we'll buy some bread. We need it for the food. We are losing housing capacity left and right here. Alright, one thing's finally turning. We need more grain farms, but we don't have the wherewithal for it. You know what we do need is customs here. Maximum trade amount to 80. That will allow our things to progress even higher. Right now our current cap was 48. But if we keep on buying grain and we keep this up and we improve our relations with them, they're going to be willing to sell us even more and more. So if we can get more and more grain in there, all the way up to, say, an 80, we'll be in good shape. So yeah, we'll hold off on the advanced mines because, well, we don't have the manpower for it. But the more we can import and export, the better. Our money is doing fine here. I mean, seriously, it's doing seriously fine. Is there anything else I can buy to help our situation out? I am not entirely sure. And we're already selling everything that needs to be sold. And making a killing while we're at it anyway. And you guys just went away? Why did you just go away? I shouldn't have built that expansion until we were stable. That was my fault. And you know what? I'm going to turn this back off again. Just to get people back in the workers' pool. And we got in vino veritas. The achievement for the Southerners for selling wine. Excellent. That's why we're so rich, by the way, is because we keep selling all this wine. I mean, yeah, some grain is getting eaten by that, but yeah, these things are only... Yeah, you guys, we gotta turn off, as one of my viewers pointed out, you guys, we gotta turn off cotton so you guys don't get confused. Alright, our flour mills are starting to spin. And these things are starting to spin as well. That makes me a little bit happier. Yeah, there was just a disruption in our bread production that caused all that malarkey. And all of our not enough food things went away. So now we just need to get our workers back in. And diligency, we got another thing coming here from now, do we give them the boots? No, we don't. We're starting to slack off on our boot production, mainly because the pigs are dead again. I do need to establish a foothold up here, and actually, with these, knowing that we can take out the vampire, I think we're pretty good. We're pretty confident at taking down these ghosts. So let us all get ready to take on some ghosts, because I ain't afraid of no ghosts. Hey, we got a military, might as well use it. How many of these freaking textiles do we have? And why aren't we making more other things? Well, because we're short on workers. I'm curious if we actually get a usable mine out of the steel or not. I've never actually taken one of these things out. Let's wait for our archers to come forth. Yeah, because we got this large of a spawn of ghosts just from the vampires mentioned, never mind the stupid vampire that we had to deal with. Make sure we tell them to attack the ghost and not the building, because we want to kill all the ghosts first, and then we tackle the building to get more to spawn. Boy, these guys had a pretty big aggro radius. And they also have the same sound effect as the turd monsters. But yeah, I think we'll do pretty well against these guys. As long as you have some melee troops to get the guys to hold still, our archers will be deadly effective. Complete surround. I love it. Okay. Oh, can we not attack the abandoned mine? Oh, it's a gold mine. Well, look at that! That actually worked out quite nicely. And heck yeah, we're going to resume extraction here. We'll just get another thing of coal miners so that our gold miner is here. Our gold digger's lodge has gone dry. So we can... Actually, we can get rid of them, because they're just taking up workers at this point. Our coal digger's lodge. How much does this make? Hang on. How much does that make? 12. So we only need one coal miner. Unless we got some iron here. But yeah, I'll take the gold. And heck, we can stone quarry while we're up here. Well, that works out nicely. Man, all that's left is this tower, the goblin village, and this other haunted haunted mine. Well, let's go on a cleanse here. No, for Pete's sake. Thank you.
Yes,
my lord. Oh, for Pete's sake, come on. Off you go. Oop, did I forget you? I forgot you guys. All right, so we'll see what economic boon we can get from here. And yeah, this will prevent any of our guys from going into melee with our archers here. This one's gonna get burned down real quick. You guys are awful at formations. All right, keep on moving on up. Now these ghosts unfortunately do resist physical attacks, but that's all we got. There we go. And it's another gold mine. Well, happy days. It's gonna be one heck of a trip, but what the hey? It's free, it's ours. And we can resume our mint production as originally planned. All right, well, in our next... Well, you know what? We'll let our guys heal up a bit. No need to send half-hit point guys into battle. Well, they didn't take all that much damage, all things considered. But, yeah, you know what? Yeah, we'll send them after the goblins. We'll let them heal for a little bit, and then we'll send them after the goblins. So, in our next episode, we will cleanse those filthy, filthy goblins. Hopefully get more of our people coming in so that we might actually have ourselves some growing population. We have solved our worker shortage for the time being, but we still have extra room for 1,500 people that we're trying to desperately lure to the village here. So if you guys like this episode and you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and leave me a comment, good, bad, or indifferent. Your feedback's always welcome. So until next time, this has been Pinstar signing out. See ya!